This is a pre-built version of the application. So if we go ahead and run this, which will create and populate an SQLite database, this one. Containing the same test data as in the original application. And next, let's go ahead and run. So the goal is that given this test data that is coming from the database, we need to use hill climbing in order to find a schedule with no conflicts. So we started with this schedule, which had five conflicts. So this is a table representation of this one. And this table lists the five conflicts. And a conflict can be one of three things for this simple application. It can be an instructor assigned to teach more than one course at the same time. So here we have this instructor, assigned to teach those two courses at the same time, meeting time 2. So Monday, Wednesday, Friday from 10 to 11. And a conflict can also be a room occupied by more than one course at the same time. So here we have room 1 is occupied by those two classes at meeting time 2. And here we have this room occupied by those two classes at meeting time 1. And a conflict can also be a course assigned to be taught in a room with a seating capacity that is smaller than the course maximum number of students, or here. So this one, this is the room capacity, and this is the maximum number of students for this course. So we started with this schedule with five conflicts, and we don't have any previous tries, so this is the first schedule we're starting with. And after zero previous or after zero tries, we end up with this schedule with four conflicts. And also after zero tries, we end up with this schedule with two conflicts. And then after three tries, we end up with this one with only one conflict. And after zero tries, we end up with this one. And this is a table representation of this schedule. So this instructor is assigned to teach those two classes, one on Monday, Wednesday, Friday from 10 to 11, and the other one on Tuesday, Thursday from 10:30 to 12. And this instructor has this one, and this one has those two classes, and this one has those two. And if we look here at the room capacity, so 45 is bigger than 25, and here same thing, etc. And this room has only this course scheduled to be taught in it, and this one have this one and this one on different times on Tuesday, Thursday, and it has those two on different times also on Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and this one have this course and this course on different times. And going back here, so those are the three departments that we have here, a math, a double E, and the physics department. And the math one has two courses that it offers, the double E 3 and the physics 2. And those are the available courses. So for each course, we have the maximum number of students for that course and the qualified instructor to teach that course. And those are the available rooms and their maximum seating capacity and the available instructors and the available meeting. Nice. I will start by creating a new project. And let's go here and copy this source code. And we need this jar file to do SQL Lite. So we go to properties, and let's create this package that will handle picking up data from the database, and let's move this one to the new package. And rename it. This will be the database name, and this will create and populate the database with the data that we had hard-coded in this prototype project. So here, so here we are creating a room table and populating it, and the meeting time table. Same thing, populating it, instructor, and course, and course instructor, and department course. And this will create and populate the database with an updated version. So here we added another department, statistics and data sciences, and we added another room and another instructor. And three additional courses. And let's replace this hard-coded data with the data coming from the database. And let's go ahead and create the updated version of the database. And let's test run the application. So we started with this data. So we have four different departments, and we have 10 courses and four rooms, five instructors, and four meeting times. And the initial schedule had seven conflicts. Those seven. And this is a table representation of that initial schedule. And here we reached a potential maxima. I had it set up so that if we try for 1,000 times, then we consider that as a potential maxima. So let's try again. Did the same thing. And here we go. So we started with those conflicts, four of them. And after four tries, we got to two conflicts. And then after nine tries, we got to one conflict. And after three tries, we ended up with this schedule with no conflicts. And let's do one more thing. Let's delete this database and go back to the original one. So let's create and populate the database. And now let's go ahead and run it again. And again, here we go. So we started with this data that is the same as in the original project. And we started here with five conflicts. And after 12 tries here, we ended up with this one with zero conflict. So this schedule.